Hello friends, Assalamu alaikum. Today we are here for another video lecture from the Department of Biotechnology and Biochemistry, JDC Kargil. Today's topic is for the students who are studying in second semester with the subject of biochemistry, and today's topic is hypersensitivity. So before moving on to the topic itself, the hypersensitivity, we will first try to know something about the immune system. So basically the immune system, we have already discussed in the classroom, the immune system is basically kind of a defensive mechanism, a defensive system of our body. So most of the time, in many of the cases, this immune system is responsible for protection of the body. So whenever there is any immune response, an immune response generation, the body is meant to protect itself. Now sometimes what happens that the immune system, you know, it causes damage to the body. When the immune system reacts in such a way that it causes damage to the body, now in this case that immune response is called as hypersensitivity. So coming to the definition, hope it's visible to you. So hypersensitivity is undesirable injurious consequences in the sensitized host following contact with specific antigen. Matlab user bhi chin se mega to agar ngatir guenuk. I'm trying to use our local language because of a response from our students that they are finding a little bit difficult to understand. So now I'll mix a local language as well here. Diri matlab kuch cheez hai na to hypersensitivity reaction hai nu undesirable response huncha de wajah se ngatir guenuk nuksan chakani cheez kado chaja ab the undesirable response kuch cheez bas generate chajin jana ka to agar natir guenu foreign cheese enter sonset the foreign cheese pe against the agar response generate so the responses was saying natir gue ka nuksan hona ka to ode reaction pula immunology terms yanu ka this cheez esin dula we call it as hypersensitivity. So this hypersensitive reaction basically are of four types. Char types ke hamare paas hypersensitive reactions hote hain. We'll discuss all these in details one by one. Type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4 type of hypersensitive reactions. So moving on to type 1 hypersensitive reactions. So type 1 hypersensitive reactions are those hypersensitive reactions which are very common type. These hypersensitive reactions are very common type. So basically what happens during hypersensitive reaction, there is allergic response. So this allergy word is being derived from basically two words. Allos means other and agons means reactivity. That means that reactivity to other molecules. So these other molecules are outside molecules. So these outside molecules, basically we call it as antigens that we have already discussed. Any foreign particle that is entering in our body, that is called as antigen. Now, whenever an antigen creates or generates an hypersensitive reaction, in that case, we call this antigen as allergen. So these outside molecules, either you breathe in or you take as food, or there can be, these molecules can come in contact with your skin. Say you take food, say for example egg, some people have allergy, and say for example mold, drugs, pollen, these are all allergens, fungi, spores. Contact with skin, if there is latex from plants, lotions we use in daily times, and sometimes soap are also allergen to some individuals. So those materials which causes allergy, all those materials are called as allergens. So this allergen, when it enters in the body, it generates response type nisiga tiryanu response generate chacha. Response generate chi chik chik po snal agar pehla time ka matir guyanu allergen chik chan aga to tu langata zarchin sensitization ya first exposure zarchin. दूसरे बारे का अगर दे इन्फेक्शन कुछ आना का तो लगाता जस्ट इन सब्सिक्वेंट एक्सपोजर से फॉर एग्जांपल दक्षिण अतीर चियोत फ्लावरिंग सीजन इट्स स्प्रिंग सीजन चुली सारा का मेंदो एवं स्तब खचिके चीज चीन उधर टाइम पे नू बहुत ज्यादा नजला जुकाम उधर न चीज सब सचिन व्हाई बिकॉज दे आर वेरी मच सेंसिटिव दैट मीन्स देयर बॉडी इज ट्राइंग टू जनरेट हाइपर सेंसिटिव रिएक्शंस अगेंस्ट दोस पोलन ग्रेन्स which has entered into their immune system. So first time agar exposure song sunte jana that is called as sensitization. Usme hamare pas memory cells banke reh jate hain. And in every season if there is exposure, that we call as subsequent exposure. After subsequent exposure, it becomes more dangerous for the individuals depending upon how much severity is this hypersensitive reaction is. So basically this allergic response has a genetic predisposition. That means some people have certain kind of information in their DNA. That information tries to form certain kind of T helper cells which are more sensitive towards certain outside allergens. Mera kehne ka matlab hai, agar kuch individuals ko there is hypersensitive reaction po ya allergy himo che induk na kato that there is something fault in their genes koi genes pe no aise kuch codes hote hain jiski wajah se dus basichi chachaku anu aise type of T helper cells banata hai jo bahut zyada sensitive hota hai kiske liye they are very much sensitive to the allergens say for example pollen to I've tried to draw a small diagram here say for example this is your DNA and this DNA it has information all the body structure this genomic DNA contains all your information so it forms your T helper cells which is more kind of a hypersensitive to outside allergens so this T helper cells when it gets an outside allergen it activates and finally it creates a response that is your type 1 hypersensitivity So type 1 hypersensitivity, what is the mechanism behind? So I have taken a snapshot from my own notebook. So I'll try to let you understand. Basically this hypersensitive reaction type 1, it is also called as IgE mediated hypersensitive reaction. This is called as IgE mediated hypersensitivity. This is very important because this can be asked as a question. Question could be objective type question for your PG entrance exam. It could be like this or for your UG exams. It could be like immunoglobulin IG responsible for type 1 hypersensitivity is. So your options could be like A IgA, B IgD, C IgE, and D IgM. So this is how objective type questions could be asked from today's topic. So you have to be very much well versed with the subject . So this type 1 hypersensitivity is also called as wheal and flare reaction. It is called as wheal and flare reaction. Or sometimes it is also called as PK reaction. After the two scientists which basically discovered this reaction, Prusnes and Krusner. These were the two scientists who basically tried to study type 1 hypersensitive reactions. So what is this wheal and flare is basically when there is type 1 hypersensitivity, there are red swollen areas, and flare means sudden recurrence. So whenever you have type 1 hypersensitive reaction, what happens? That you have red swollen areas over your surface of skin, and in addition to this, these red spots over the skin, they appear very suddenly. You don't know. Say for example, you have taken certain eggs in the morning, and after a while, within 5 or 10 minutes, your body starts getting reddened. So that means you have allergy to that albumin protein which is present in egg. So this is how takes place. So what is the mechanism behind, what is the biology, what is the immunology behind this type 1 hypersensitivity is, say for example, there is a human, these are the lungs, so it takes pollen grains from outside. Fistana khus guin angus pe pollen grains lene, and yahan pe iske bronchus epithelial lining pe it gets exchanged into the lymphatic system. अब ये lymphatic system में आ जाती है. When it comes into the lymphatic system, this lymphatic system have cells. ये हमारे पास कुछ ऐसे type of cells होते हैं. So these are called as antigen presenting cells. Short पे हम इनको कहते हैं APCs. These antigen presenting cells, basically what are these is, these are either can be dendritic cells or it can be macrophages. Dendritic cells and macrophages, they act as antigen presenting cells. Now this pollen grain which has entered into the body through the respiratory system, they are being taken by these dendritic or the macrophages, and then they form antigen presenting cells. Now because they are foreign, so these antigen presenting cells, they will represent the small antigen with few epitopes over MHC, major histocompatibility complex 2 molecules. MHC 2 molecules ke upar antigen presenting cells usko represent karega. Ye humne class mein already discuss kiya hai. So these MHC molecules, now they are in search of a cell, that those are T cells for further activation. Ab ye jo hamare paas MHC molecules hain, they are in search of MHC2 molecule, antigen presenting cell with a small epitope of the allergen. This is your antigen presenting cell, this is MHC molecule, this is the epitope of the antigen. मतलब छोटा सा छुनसे fragment सी उधे pollen grain ही जो process करके इसके साथ bind करके surface सी खाते के फिर से, ठीक है? Now when this will now move into the lymphatic system, जो lymph nodes में चला जाता है. Lymph nodes and lymph nodes, it comes in contact with T helper cells. T helper cells, they have T cell receptors over there, जिनको हम TCR कहते हैं. These T helper cells, when it comes in contact with MHC2 molecules of antigen presenting cells, what happens? There is co-stimulation. So these T helper cells are CD4 positive, cluster of differentiation 4 positive. So this CD4 positive, what it does, it co-stimulates the antigen presenting cell. What does this co-stimulation does? This co-stimulation leads to further activation of other cells with the help of certain soluble molecules. Those certain soluble molecules are called as interleukins. So these interleukins can be IL-4, IL-5 and IL-10. So IL-4 and IL-10 are basically responsible for activation of B cell, and IL-5 is responsible for activation of eosinophils. So eosinophils, there is granulation of eosinophils, and there is again rashes and eczema kind of nature in those hypersensitive patients. So this, what this IL-4 And IL-10 does is basically, so this IL-4 and IL-10 then goes over the B cells. Say for example, this is my B cell. So this B cell, when it does not have any information from outside, so it is already producing immunoglobulin M molecules. IgM ये already produce कर रहा होता है, ठीक है? IgM molecule जो पहला ना produce बने होते हैं, अब इनके ऊपर receptors होते हैं. ये receptor निकल जब हमारे पास interleukin बैठ जाता है, दिखाते हो जब interleukin दुख ना करता हो, अब ये क्या होता है? Instead of producing IgM, अब ये IgM को बनाना दूस बन बसता जाए, देर कितना? Now it suddenly starts producing immunoglobulin E molecules, ठीक है? ये हमारे पास आ गया, that is why we called as IgE mediated hypersensitivity. So this IgE, what it does? Now it will start moving towards another target cell with high content of granules. These are called as mast cells. Fine. So the process here, IL-4, it comes on binds here. IL-4, jab antigen presenting cell se kena bin se unse B cell receptor pe ke dukcha. B cell receptor pe ke dukpana, what happens? This B cell basically instead of khus IgM produce bhi jage ke khus chi bacha, IgE produce bacha. IgE dekhen asun se gar bind bacha, mast cell receptor ka. That is called as Fc receptors of mast cells. Inko hum Fc receptors dashchinya. Fc receptors. So the process where there are IgM B cells, instead of formation of IgM, it starts producing IgE. This whole process is called as class switching. So switching of one class of immunoglobulin from the other. IgM se IgE classic group goes produce bacha. Now this IgE goes and binds over the Fc receptors of mast cells. So it is something like this. I'll try to draw it here. So this is my mast cell granules, and these are Fc receptors. Now these IgE molecules comes and binds over here. Fine. ये यहाँ पे आके इधर bind कर जाती है. Now what happens? I have already said that there are two exposures. First is sensitization and another one is second exposure. So the moment, say in another season, ये हमारे पास mast cell वहां पर बने होंगे, Fc receptor के साथ bind करके रह जाएंगे, या दूसरा exposure एक दो दिन में, if this pollen grain again enters into the system of that person, now it does not activate all these processes, it directly comes and cross-links all these two Fc receptors. ये हमारे पास IgE immunoglobulin के ऊपर जाके Fab portion के ऊपर bind कर जाता है. दूर लगाते हैं Fc regeneration दूर ला fragment of antigen binding Fab regeneration. दिली खाते के दुख से नती दे pollen grain पे उसे bind बसे दुख जाए. So this whole process is called as cross-linking. Now after cross-linking, what happens is that this starts degranulation. Mast cells starting degranulating, and the most prominent chemical which is being released is histamine. Now what this histamine does is basically it does two things. It is responsible for bronchus contract and vasodilation. So bronchus contract में क्या होती है? In bronchus contract what happens? जो हमारे पास bronchioles हैं, वो shrink हो जाते हैं. Because of that shrinking, there is very little exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide from the blood and the lungs environment. What happens after that? That individual starts suffocating. मतलब उसको लगता है कि उसका सांस बंद हो रहा है, ही इज गॉट ऑक्सीजन. सो दिस ब्रोंकस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फाइनली लीड्स टू डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीथिंग एंड वैसोडाइलेशन. वैसोडाइलेशन में व्हाट हैपेंस, दीज आर आवर ब्लड वेसल्स, देयर इज एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग. व्हेन दीज हिस्टामिन्स एक्ट्स ऑन द एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग ऑफ द सरफेस ऑफ दीज ब्लड वेसल्स, दे यू नो स्ट्रेचेस आउट एंड you know WBCs all comes into these interstitial spaces and finally there is leads to swelling or we call it as edema. So this is how you know prophylaxis, we can say, symptoms comes out in case of type 1 hypersensitive reactions. So this is again trying to understand what this type 1 hypersensitive reaction does. This is basically vasodilation with the help of histamine, and because of this there is edema and swelling, and again this histamine is also responsible for activation of eosinophils, which finally releases certain kind of proteins which are basically proteases. They are responsible for digestion of another important proteins which are present within the cells. And it also further activates, another mediators also activate these eosinophils further. So mediators could be histamine, leukotrienes, prostaglandin, neutrophils and proteases. So smooth muscle contraction, what are the mediators? These are histamine, leukotriene and prostaglandins. So what are the chemicals responsible? Leukocyte, extravasation, these are cytokines, leukotrienes and chemotactic factors. Chemotactic factors are those chemicals which are responsible for attraction of neutrophils and eosinophils over a certain area in the body. So examples of type 1 hypersensitive reactions, these are again these diseases you have to memorize. So allergic asthma, some people have you know breathing problems. Allergic conjunctivitis, some people have problem with their eyes when there are allergic substances roaming around. So allergic rhinitis, watery is the, you know, in this disease these are the symptoms. You have watery eyes, you have sneezing, you have itching. Angioedema, there is swelling under the skin. And urticaria, there is rashes over the skin. So these are all the diseases associated with type 1 hypersensitive reactions. There are different drugs which are responsible for the treatment of these type 1 hypersensitive reactions. You can use adrenaline, hydrocortisone, phenamine and